Welcome everyone, I am Bastien Serré and I will do a short presentation of our paper, A Lazy Query Scheme for Reachability Analysis in PetriNet. This is joint work with Didier Lim and Louis Jezekel conducted during my PhD studies. As an example, let's consider the PetriNet N. One wants to know if the marking M1 is reachable. To do so, our algorithm will try to build a subnet of N which is as small as possible while allowing to show if M1 is reachable or not. Consider P2 first. The only way to mark it is to fire T1. For firing T1, the place P1 needs to be marked. The subnet N1 suffices to guarantee that P2 can be marked in the original net N because the full preset of each transition is considered. We call it P-complete. Applying the same process to P3, one gets the subnet N2 that is also P-complete and suffices to guarantee that P3 can be reached in N. Notice that P4 and T3 appear neither in N1 nor in N2. This part of N will not be used to conclude. We have shown that P2 and P3 can be marked independently. However, the subnets N1 and N2 are not disjoint. So it's not possible to guarantee that yet that P2 and P3 can be marked together. To guarantee that, we merge N1 and N2 on common places and transition. In general, the result of a merge may need to be extended. However, in this particular case, it allows to conclude that the marking M1 is reachable. One could wonder how our algorithm behaves with non-reachable markings. Let's consider the non-reachable marking M2. Using the same construction as before for P4, one gets the only way to mark it is to use T2, and that it will need to be unmarked by T3 to get an odd number of tokens in it. Finally, to fire T2, there is a need for token in P1. All the transitions that could add token to places in entry are considered. We say that entry is T-complete. And all the transitions that could remove token from P4 are considered. We say that entry is M-complete. And M2 is not reachable in N3. This allows to prove that M2 is not reachable in the original net N. In the paper, we formalize the algorithm that I just sketched here, and we show that this is soon incomplete when used on unbounded PetriNet. Moreover, we show that how a similar algorithm can be used for reachability analysis in bounded PetriNets with inhibitor arcs. Constructing subnets with inhibitor arcs is not very different from what we have shown in this presentation. However, connecting a reachability is more involved because subnets that are not P-complete can be unbounded, even for bounded nets. Finally, this algorithm has been implemented in the Romeo model checker and tested on benchmark from the model checking contest, which is also discussed in the paper. Thank you for your attention.